Welcome to our video review of Dance Central 2. What's really interesting about Dance Central 2 is that it takes the formula of Dance Central 1 and changes it such that it becomes an even better and more immersive game. So we have all the usual options right here: dance, crew challenge, fitness, options, buy new dancers that you want for the downloadable content. The crew challenge is kind of like a story mode where you can level up and learn dance moves from different dance crews and finally unlock all the hidden characters in the game. But the main content of the game itself is in the dance function, of which you have all the different options, and you have all the list of songs that you're used to, either those that you imported from Dance Central 1, those that you downloaded and paid money for, or even those that just came in the game, all 44 songs. And there's a whole list of songs available in Dance Central 2, from Baby Got Back, Bad Romance, Bruno Mars Grenade. There's even a Japanese boy band called Exile with a song called I Wish For You, and really this really has the whole range of songs that that anybody could wish for. And even better than that, this upon selection of a song, you get to see a little sample of how the song is performed. It gives you an idea of how difficult the song is. So right now, let's just go into the break it down mode, which is the practice mode of Dance Central 2. This works similar to Dance Central 1, except in this case, you get to choose the moves that you're not great at. For those perfectionists out there, this is really a huge upgrade over what most of us are used to in Dance Central 1. Alright, so you have the options to go full song session, but really what we want to focus on is the focus on select moves. So you have a whole list of songs, they show you what all the moves look like. I mean, you can't go wrong with this. This is like the perfect way to learn a dance, even well enough to perform it on stage. So let's just go through this list and let's just try and find a move which might be a bit tricky. This one looks pretty tricky, so let's just select it and go all the way down and dance. So right, we launch right into the practice mode of Dance Central 2, and in this case what we're gonna do is just gonna keep practicing this move over and over again. So in this case, we're gonna go into the performant mode, which is the basic performance mode for Dance Central 2. In this case, we have a Bruno Mars Grenade, and so what I'm going to show you is something different from Dance Central 1. Back in Dance Central 1, all you could do is perform it by yourself, and you do get the whole floor to yourself, but as a party game, that kind of makes Dance Central 1 not as desirable. But this is just a whole level ahead, and what you get is so we're starting off with a single player version of the song, and here we go, and it just focuses on one guy. And let's say one of your friends in the party decides, hey, you know what, I'm gonna join in, and he or she can just step right in and just raise their hands and just join in the song. This allows you just to jump in and jump out of the song anytime you want. If you're feeling tired and you had enough, you're just gonna step out to the side for a while and it just changes back to one player mode. This just really makes the game quite a great party game. Alright, and right now we're just gonna focus on the dance battle mode, which this is like probably the biggest improvement in Dance Central 2. And what you get to do is you choose the song that you want, you choose the crew that you want. So you represent different crews in challenging each other. And so the song starts, you have the basic dancing mode, and sometimes the spotlight just focuses on one character. And what this means is that you earn double points for the move that you complete. It's kind of like, you know, this is your time to shine, you better do well. And other times there's another dance battle mode. This is the most interesting one, dance any move. And what you get to do is you just perform the move that they show on the screen. More purists might say, you know, this could just goes against choreography and all that, but this really makes it really fun. You fight for the moves, you fight for the gold cards, which are worth the most points. And this is when the competition gets really frantic and the game just gets that whole extra level of fun. Finally, we have the voice mode, and what this allows you to do is to just say Xbox dance, repeat some commands, and you get to pretty much control the console. When your arms are really tired, can't move anymore, you know, that's when your voice comes in handy. And this is a bit of a gimmick really, and it doesn't always work, but when it does, it's pretty fun. Alright, so that marks the end of our Dance Central 2 review. I think what you really notice in from all the various songs that we've shown you so far is that the dance moves are not just more difficult, they're actually more intricate and more fluid, such that you can really get into the moves much better than last time. And in this case, this really makes Dance Central 2 a huge leap forward over Dance Central 1 and makes it a highly recommended game. It's worth 4.5 of over 5 stars.
That was a preview. I'm in for the movie.